Okay, so now I'm still in this evolution, my evolution series. And yes, I am Homo Habilis. I recognize this upper top light really shows it. You've seen my collarbone here, this area. We're very much a mimicker look. Now, maybe just me, but they did come out of the Tanzania, and it's very interesting, that group. They didn't have much hair, I noticed. They're starting to lose their hair. And so it was a time where they had a lot of climate changes going on. We had, sometimes it was woodland, sometimes it went to savanna, sometimes it went back to woodland. So it was really like doing this a lot. We were having a lot of big changes in the environment. So that was probably part of the reason. But when we're getting out of these trees, so when we're, I'm really talking about the leave, you know, and was there a group that got to stay? Yes, there were many groups that got to stay, and yet there were some that traveled away. Okay, so now, what is the reason for their traveling away and out into the savannah? Is it really gonna go back to, hey, were we just kicked out? You know, was this Habilis group kicked out? And I'm looking at I'm looking at the rendition they made. They made the mask, the whole bustier of Habilis. It doesn't look like a monkey that was oversexed, that was trying to overpopulate and just be a pain. It didn't look like that, you know. It doesn't look like that type of creature. So I'm a little confused, because I would think that would be the reason. It's like, you've got all of a sudden a bunch of pervert monkeys, just get out of here, you guys are a pain and you're overpopulating, and so we have some aggressors come in and kick us out. That I can understand. But it didn't happen that way, it doesn't seem that way. When I see the eyes, we have lots of practically almost the tear markings. You know, when you cry too much, you get lots of bags under your eyes. Lots of sorrow starting to exist in that face. And it's very interesting. So the reason for the leaving, I don't believe it is that quick jump that we were just jerks overpopulating, like some monkeys in the zoo. You know, when they cram them all together, they can't help it. I don't believe that was the reason, even though that's what they are now, the human beings have become now. I don't think it was the reason back then. So I believe it was from a sad reason. A sad reason, I believe, you know, history will tell. Our studies of history will tell. But what would it have been? Could it have been plagues? Could it have been, you know, just forest devastation, a massive fire, those types of things, you know, those, you know, all of a sudden, our trees are gone, lost many families, and so then they out travel and kind of just exist on their own quite a bit. And it seems like that was more going on, rather than this jerk human being all of a sudden being in the trees, you know, that we can foresee. We can go, oh yeah, what a jerk human being, kick them out. That would be our, you know, our number one thought, that would be why we were no longer allowed in the forest. So Habilis here with starting to lose the hair. And so I'm looking at the hair loss being associated with the change of diet, definitely the hair loss, losing that they have that here. All of a sudden, they're starting to have a naked upper body. It's just an incredible time. So I'm gonna put. I hope I can do. Yeah, I'll try to save that image and I'll put it on the front of this. And it's, yeah, our Habilis self. Yeah.